Hi guys, this is Jordan with Motion Array. Today, we're going to be looking at how to add subtitles in Premiere Pro. No matter who you are, this is a useful skill to know how to do, because at some point in time, whether you're working on a small project, a feature-length film, or a YouTube video, you're undoubtedly at some point in time going to need to write out exactly what the characters are saying, or give secondary information, etc. Thankfully, Premiere has a built-in function to help make subtitles quickly and easily. But let's first distinguish that if you're looking for a tutorial on simple text, that's not what this is. In fact, we already did a video on that, and it's this one here. And the link for that is in the description below. Instead, what we're focusing on is specifically subtitles, which Premiere Pro refers to as captions. So, let's jump into Premiere Pro and learn about how to make captions. So we have our clip here already on our timeline, and we want to add some subtitles to go along with what the person is saying. Let's take a quick listen first.
But as an editor, one of your biggest limitations is the footage that you have to work with.
While you may know how to add simple text, Premiere actually has a separate method specific for creating captions. Go to File, New, Captions, or right-click in your Project Manager and select a new item, Captions. From here, you have the new Captions window. Basically, how it works is that under the Standard section, you can choose the format of the captions you want. There's three options here for different types of closed captions, and there's one option for open captions. Here's all you need to know about closed versus open captions. Closed captions can be turned on and off, even after your video's been exported. Kind of like subtitles on a DVD, or like the subtitles you can turn on and off on YouTube. While open captions are permanently on top of your video and cannot be removed after you export. It's your choice between what you need, but if you're gonna go with closed captions to be turned on and off, you'll want to go with CEA 708. While if you want your subtitles to be baked into your video, go with open captions. We're going to explore both, but to start with, let's go with open captions. Let's start by dragging our open captions box onto our timeline, over top of our footage. To edit the text that displays over your video, double-click on your captions box. Or enable the captions tab by going to Window, Captions. Next, here in your caption editor, type in the phrase that you want your caption to say. Now let's go over to our video track here and extend the width of it so that we can see more of our captions box. Do this by using your scroll wheel while hovering over this part of the track. From here you can see that you have a little tab that you can extend for the length of your caption. So let's see how long our subject is actually speaking their first line for.
But as an editor, one of your biggest limitations—
Great! Now let's drag the caption tab to match. It's important to remember that the captions box holds multiple captions tabs. Now that we've changed our caption length, we want to orient it to the place where we want it to show. We want our text to be centered at the bottom, which is what it is by default. But over here on this grid, you can choose a different area for your captions to be located. Centered at the top, on the corners, etc. Right now, let's just keep it centered at the bottom. Now that we made one caption, if we need to add more captions, simply go to the plus icon here and click it to add a new caption line. If you want to delete captions, simply highlight it and hit the minus button. Repeat the process for as many subtitles as you need to create. Some people prefer a little space between the lines of text so that it's a subtle nudge for anyone reading it that the captions have changed. Once you finish creating your captions, we want to style our text so that it looks a little bit different. At the top of your captions tab, you can change the font, color, size, whether or not it has a stroke, the color of the stroke. There's a lot of different options. And if you want to make changes across all of your captions, right-click and hit Select All, and then make your changes accordingly. For us, we're going to have traditionally yellow captions with a bit of a more modern font. Fun little fact, if you've ever seen those little musical notes that subtitles have whenever there's music playing, well, you can add those simply by clicking this button right here. Play around with it and see what you like for your captions. And that's how you create open captions. Let's take a look at our final product.
But as an editor, one of your biggest limitations is the footage that you have to work with.
But how do you make closed captions? Well, let's do that together. Go to New Captions, and under Standard, choose CEA 708. It's just the most up-to-date standard. Unless you want to support more than one language, you don't need to worry about the stream. This is why you can have subtitles available in one video file for multiple languages. So it doesn't matter if your audience speaks English, Spanish, French, Arabic. You can have languages available for your audience to choose from. Now that you've set up your captions to be closed captions, if you try to add text, you'll see that it doesn't really do anything. For closed captions, we actually need to enable them manually. Go to your button editor here, and look for the symbol that looks like a speech bubble, which is the closed captions display. Drag it onto your button editor, and then click it to highlight it blue, and your captions will now be enabled and visible. Once you start to type in your text, you'll notice that it looks different than the open captions. It's white text on a black solid. And after a minute or two, you'll probably notice also that these captions don't really have the option to change their style. This is because closed captions are put into a basic form, where they can be read and styled specifically to the medium that they're being played on. So if your video ends up being played on YouTube, through VLC player, or on a DVD, each of those different options will be able to style their text differently. Once you're finished, go to File, Export, and then down to your Captions option tab here. In order to have your subtitles able to be turned on and off at different points of your choosing, we'll need to have a separate file that tells the video player how to treat your video. This is called a sidecar file, and if you select that option, you can choose what form you'd like to use. Depending on your needs, you can choose what works for your situation, but a good safe option is SubRip SRT format. Once you've exported, you're ready to go! Congratulations, you've made your subtitles. I hope you guys found this video helpful. If you did, we've got tons of other tutorials over at motionarray.com. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.